He is known for his position as a justice of the peace and an officer of the county militia in the 1630s. He is recognized for his involvement in opposing the Long Parliament and standing surety for the release of his imprisoned friend. His name is Robert Filmer. Robert Filmer, the eldest child of Sir Edward Filmer and Elizabeth Filmer, was born into a distinguished family in East Sutton, Kent. From a young age, he displayed a thirst for knowledge and enrolled at Trinity College, Cambridge in 1604. Although he did not complete his degree, he was admitted to Lincoln's Inn and was called to the bar in 1613. However, there is no evidence to suggest that he pursued a career in law. Instead, Filmer found himself drawn to the world of politics and acquired the Porter's Lodge at Westminster Abbey as his townhouse. In 1618, he married Anne Heaton, and they began a family together. Filmer's involvement in supporting the monarchy became evident when he stood surety for the release of his friend Sir Roger Twisden, who had been imprisoned for opposing the Long Parliament. As tensions heightened, the parliamentary army pillaged Filmer's manor house in 1642, and his properties were heavily taxed to fund the parliamentary cause. Despite being investigated by the county committee for his alleged support of the king, no solid evidence was found against Filmer. However, he was imprisoned for several years in Leeds Castle, and his estates were sequestered. Filmer passed away around May 26, 1653, and was laid to rest in East Sutton, surrounded by his descendants. He left behind his wife, three sons, and one daughter, with his son Robert eventually being elevated to the first Filmer baronet in 1674. Robert Filmer, a prominent philosopher of his time, found himself drawn into the controversy between the king and the House of Commons, which ignited his literary pursuits. His writings aligned with the extreme section of the Divine Right Party, providing insights into their doctrines. His most comprehensive work, Patriarcha, or The Natural Power of Kings, was published posthumously in 1680. However, Christopher Hill notes that the entire argument of this work, as well as Filmer's earlier publications in the 1640s and 1650s, was rooted in Old Testament history, starting from Genesis onwards. Filmer's ideas began to take shape through his published works during his lifetime. Of the Blasphemy Against the Holy Ghost, written around 1646 or 1647, challenged the doctrines of Calvinists, particularly John Calvin's teachings on blasphemy. The Freeholders' Grand Inquest delved into English constitutional history. However, these early works received little attention, and Patriarcha only circulated in manuscript form. Filmer's Anarchy of a Limited and Mixed Monarchy was a direct response to Philip Hunton's treatise on monarchy, asserting that the king's prerogative should not be subordinate to the authority of Parliament. In 1652, he published Observations Concerning the Original of Government upon Mr. Hobbes's Leviathan, Mr. Milton Against Salmasius, and H. Grotius de jure belli ac pacis. This pamphlet challenged the political classics of Grotius, Milton, and Hobbes. In 1680, The Power of Kings, and in particular, of the King of England, was released. This work further explored the authority and power of monarchs, specifically focusing on the King of England. Filmer's philosophical works, based on biblical narratives and historical events, provided a foundation for the Divine Right Party's beliefs. While his ideas may not have gained widespread recognition during his lifetime, his writings continue to offer valuable insights into the nature of power and governance. Robert Filmer, a prominent philosopher of his time, held a unique perspective on the origins and nature of government. According to Filmer, the government of a family by the father serves as the true foundation and model for all forms of governance. He believed that this authority originated from God, who granted Adam complete control over his descendants, even extending to matters of life and death. This divine authority was then passed down through generations, from Adam to Noah, and further to the patriarchs Shem, Ham, and Japheth. Filmer argued that the power exercised by these patriarchs over their families and servants was absolute and derived from divine right. He maintained that all kings and governors in society derived their authority from these patriarchs, thus making their rule absolute and untouchable. In Filmer's view, the king held a position above any human control, unaffected by the acts of his predecessors or even his own actions. He believed that a law could only be imposed upon an individual by another, and a person could not self-impose a law. Regarding the English Constitution, Filmer asserted that the Lords served solely as advisors to the king, while the Commons were limited to performing and consenting to the ordinances of Parliament. He emphasized that the king alone possessed the power to make laws, as they derived their authority solely from his will. Filmer vehemently opposed the idea that the people could judge or depose their king, as he believed it would grant individuals the power to judge their own cause, which he deemed unacceptable. Furthermore, Filmer held a critical view of democracy, particularly ancient Athenian democracy, which he deemed a justice-trading system. He argued that the Athenians never truly experienced justice but rather succumbed to the will of the mob. According to Filmer, it was only after the establishment of the Roman Empire that fair rule was achieved in ancient Rome. Filmer's philosophy, though controversial, offers valuable insights into the origins and nature of government. It encourages us to ponder the source of authority and the role of divine right in shaping our understanding of governance. While his views may not align with contemporary notions of democracy and popular sovereignty, they serve as a reminder to critically examine the foundations of our political systems and the balance between individual rights and centralized power.
Do you want to explore more philosophers? Who do you want to see featured next? Subscribe and leave a comment below to let me know. I'll see you in the next video.